But,
Que Dios te dan.
How are we doing on God? Have we gone too far?
No way.
No.
More!
No. Y'all are the boss. I'm asking the boss.
Fuck it up, dog.
We got the word. So, we'll go easy. We want to respect the space. But, yes, we're going to do another one. We're going to do this track. It's called The Shrieking Phenomenon. And it's a cool track. It's in Sanskrit. It's based on a prayer. It's sung in praise of a lion from another planet. An extraterrestrial lion that's spoken of in the Vedas. This lion is named Shrinkadev, and he descended to this earth like 100 million years ago, believe it or not. You might ask, why did an extraterrestrial lion descend to planet Earth? Well, there's a whole long story I could go into, but I will tell you this. Back then, people lived very, very long lives. And they would perform great penances, great austerities to gain specific powers that they desired. And there was one great demon by the name of Hiranyakashipu. And what did he do? But he stood on one leg for like 1,000 years because he desired to live forever. So he stood on this one leg. And all the demigods were flipping out. They were like, dude, get off that leg. You're making me tired. And not only that, but all the ants and the insects, they had eaten all his flesh. So he was just a skeleton standing there on one leg, his prana, his life force, holding it together. And they were like, yo, dude, quit it. What do you want? You've been doing this shit for too long. So he said to their mom, he said, I want to live forever. Brahma said, no way, I can't do that. I don't even live forever. How am I going to give you that power? Okay, well, here's what I can do. I can make it so you won't die on land or in water. I can make it so you won't die during day or night by the hand of a man or a beast. I'll make it so you can't die on the ground or in the air.
Inside or outside.
Inside or outside. By no weapon. So that sounds pretty much like, eternal. So he was sighing, no one was touching him, and then he ruled this earth with an iron fist. Even worse than today, believe it or not. He was the greatest demon. And, something happened he did not expect. He had a son, and he was raising his son to be another great demon in a succession of demons. So what did he do? He sent him to the demon school. It's like a big fancy private school where all the demons chill and learn how to fuck people over and, live by lies and deceit. And this little kid, Pramod, that was his name, he saw through all that shit. He saw that it was false. That if you base your life on deceit and on lies and deception, you really won't get anywhere. Will you be happy? No. Not at all. He saw that he must live in truth and in light and in purity. And that's where strength comes from. So he was sharing this with all his little demon friends in the playground. And since he spoke from realization, they totally understood. They got on board. And before he knew it, the headmasters saw that he was messing with their whole curriculum. So they told his father, they told Hiranyakashipu, dude, your son, he is talking some crazy shit. He's messing with this whole curriculum you got. He's no demon. And so it was the other way around. These demons saw Prahlad as demon number one. So what did his father do? He went from stroking him on the head, loving him like his little son, to throwing him on the ground and trying to chop his head off. That's how much of a demon he was. So, no matter how hard he tried, he could not kill his son. He tried and tried, he threw him in a pit of snakes. He threw him on a cliff. He fed him poison. He had his guards try and kill him with big leg tridents and spears and shit. He tried like 100 ways, you know, I saw on a twisted book, it was like 100 ways to kill a rabbit or something. Maybe y'all saw that. It was like a little cartoon thing. But this is like 1,000 ways to kill Pilat. But none of them worked. And so Hiranyakashipu, he was baffled because he saw in his son a source of strength greater than his own. And he said one day, he said to his son, "What is the source of your power? Where is it? You say it's everywhere. You know, you say it's the divine. You say it's love, but where is it? Is it in that MacBook Pro, mid-2012, with upgraded RAM and a second hard drive? Could it be in there?
Nope.
No.
Is it in that Chauvet Slim Car LED 56 light that has red, green, and blue colors and a few mixtures?
I'm thinking.
Is that the source of your power?" And Hiranyakashipu, he grew so enraged, he took his club and he destroyed that light. He burst it, and the printed circuit board went everywhere. LEDs went flying. And lo and behold, what popped out? But Nasringadev, an extraterrestrial lion from a whole other planet with nails longer than your face. This lion's like 12 foot tall. It's like way worse than anything from Are You Afraid of the Dark? You know, that shit freaked me out when I was kid. There was one dude who walked out of a mirror and he had nails like this long. And he would poke them into your cornea or whatever. But he was just like a skinny, pale white dude that looked like a witch house guy or something. Like he was in Salem or something. But this is a lion, you know, this is fierce. And so this lion, he was actually Vishnu incarnate. He was the protector of Pilat this whole time. And even though he was based in faith and in goodness and in purity, he came out as a bloodthirsty lion, ready to demolish this demon and disembowel him with his claws and wear his intestines around his neck. So if y'all are ever chilling in a Hindu temple and you're sitting down to eat your food and it's all good, and then you look up and you see a picture of a lion wearing some dude's intestines while he's dangling on his lap with blood flowing from his eyes and all his orifices. If you see that, you know what's up. So that's what the song is about, and we're gonna do it. Sorry for the long-winded explanation.
Thank you.
In the back, we got t-shirts. We got cassettes. We got free zines. And we're out of stickers. We have stickers. So check it out. It helps us keep going on the road. We got like
1 month left.
A month left. So get us back.